only 30 seconds left in the ball game, and the crowd is wild. A scramble under UU's basket. Hand of the pass. West shoots. Another. No good. Another. Not good. Another. And it's in. And the all ball game. No, it's not. Yes. Wow, what a beautiful defense. He's open for a shot. This might be it. Rapidly disappearing. 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Merrithew shoots, and he's in. I mean, it's in. Yes. And there's the final gun. PU 36, UU 35. The upstate boys really came through, and just listen to those PU fans.
Hail to victory for OP.
Thank you. Thank you. Some of the celebrity guest stars Ed Asner, C-3PO, and R2-D2 from Star Wars, Kenny Rogers, and Donna Summer.
My name is Donna. I'm a duck.
Welcome to Donald Duck's 50th birthday celebration. Donald Duck's 50th birthday is hosted by Dick Van Dyke.
Mickey and Minnie arrive with the cake. Daisy and Goofy bring Ludwig von Drey. Dewey and Louie and Uncle Scrooge too.
Your birthday.
They sing, Dear Donald, happy birthday to you.
Only truly great stars have been able to celebrate 50 triumphant years in show business. The key to Donald's success is the fact that he is the most human of all cartoon characters. He's the one we can relate to most. In a moment, I'll be chatting with the living legend himself.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Dick Van Dyke coming to you from Hollywood Burbank Airport here in Los Angeles, where the final preparations for the event of 1984 being made. It's obvious even to the smallest child that the moment America has been waiting for is about to arrive. Now behind me stands Duck One, which will take Donald coast to coast on a whirlwind tour, culminating in a giant parade in his honor at Disneyland. Hey, what's going on? He's gone. Did anybody tell him he had an interview with me?
Come on, Donald. You know where the seatbelt goes. Love to show off, don't you?
Huh? Ladies and gentlemen, our exclusive interview with Donald will have to take place at a later time. Oh, this is just great. This is just swell. So what time's the next flight to Seattle?
Can you quack like Donald Duck?
In the next hour, we'll see how the legendary American hero's 50th birthday is being celebrated around the world as Donald receives awards, medals, and keys to dozens of cities.
Joining Dick tonight to wish Donald happy birthday will be these guest stars. Ed Asner, C-3PO, Bruce Jenner, Cloris Leachman, John Ritter, Kenny Rogers, R2-D2, Donna Summer, Andy Warhol, and Henry Winkler.
Happy birthday, Donald.
Happy birthday, Donald!
I finally caught up with Donald Duck back at the Disney studio. His dressing room is just off Dopey Drive.
Hi, Donald. I just wanted to congratulate you on your 50th birthday and to tell you that I personally have never had a hard time understanding you.
Thank you.
Beg pardon?
Can you get me
that? Did I get you that? No. No.
Then what did you get me?
Nothing. I forgot.
You forgot.
I was more concerned about the interview. I wanted to make sure I didn't forget to mention your kind, lovable...
God.
Nature.
My sweet disposition.
Oh, your feet are in position.
My sweet disposition.
Oh, your sweet disposition.
Yes, I've always had it. I remember the first time Mickey invited me to play with his band.
Well, that's not exactly how it happened. Donald seldom waited for invitations. He just jumped right in. And that started a rivalry with Mickey that's still going strong today. Like many controversial figures, Donald's actual birth date is shrouded in mystery. Rumor has it that although the egg was laid on Friday the 13th, March 1934, he wasn't hatched until June 9th, nearly 3 months later, which probably accounts for his belligerent nature. Even as a toddler, the outside world always had a way of getting at Donald.
Oh, baby boy.
Of course, everyone thought these temper tantrums were simply childhood growing pains, and they hoped that as he grew up and as his beak acquired a little more character, that his attitude might soften up a little. And it did. But just a little. An explosive personality like Donald's was a natural for Hollywood and the silver screen. Today, Donald is honored for being one of the film world's true giants.
Out there, he's everywhere.
Who?
Our friend Donald. He dresses neat. Just can't be beat. Taps his happy feet. Our friend Donald.
Donald was immortalized here at Hollywood's Chinese Theater when his webbed feet were captured forever in cement. No wonder he's long been one of our favorite movie idols. You know, you can tell immediately from the way an actor walks or talks if he's destined for stardom. And even from Donald's debut appearance in The Wise Little Hen, it was obvious he had just the right amount of charm to capture the public's attention. That performance led to bigger and bigger roles. It was just a matter of time before greats and non-greats were begging him for favors and autographs.
Well, you should be careful.
And you're Donald Duck.
Donald Duck? Donald Duck?
Donald Duck.
Soon, Donald was a full-fledged star, living the big life, adored by millions, hobnobbing with celebrities, ignoring his old friends.
Hello!
Hello, Donald. This is Walt.
What? Not who?
Disney.
Disney? Oh, my God.
If it weren't for Walt Disney's extraordinary creativity, there'd be no Donald, or Mickey for that matter, two of the most popular and best-loved cartoon characters.
One of the greatest satisfactions in our work here at the studio is the warm relationship that exists within our cartoon family. Mickey, Pluto, Goofy, and the whole gang have always been a lot of fun to work with. But like many large families, we have a problem child. You're right, it's Donald Duck. Come on out.
No, sir. Get me out of it.
Oh, come on, Donald. You'll enjoy this next demonstration.
No. Absolutely not.
Donald, the people are waiting.
Hello. No matter how sophisticated our civilization becomes, clarity of speech and enunciation will remain vitally important to the understanding of languages of the future. Forms of life which do not possess these qualities are, in my humble opinion, doomed. Of course, there are exceptions to every rule, in particular the voice of Donald Duck, Mr. Ducky Nash. Artu understands him perfectly, or so he says. No, I haven't forgotten. Happy birthday, Mr. Duck, and Mr. Nash.
Here's Clarence Ducky Nash in 1942 recording Donald the Opera Star. Nash's unique and wonderful voice is one of the keys to Donald's continued success.
I've done the voice of Donald Duck for the last 50 years.
The duck and I have always gotten along, except for that one time when he was at the studio reading his fan mail.
Dear Donald, I can't understand a word you say.
Mr. Duck?
Send my voice in here.
Your voice? Oh, Clarence Nash. Yes, I'll send him right in.
Hi, Donald. Boy, what a beautiful day for the little creatures.
What's good about it?
Why, the birds are singing.
Big guess.
Can't understand me.
Me, you fathead.
Oh, can't understand you. Must be that flat beak of yours. Can't mouth the words right.
Why, you pigeon brain, you just don't like kicking it.
Oh, yeah? Well, listen to this.
Then you pop a pig, a pig, a pig, a pig, a fool. Can't understand it myself. I'm gonna give me a new voice.
And that's exactly what Donald did in this 1947 cartoon, where he bought some magic pills.
I wonder if you will really help my voice. Well, just one way to find out. Well, why don't you
say something? One, two, three, four. Testing.
I can talk. Oh, boy, I can talk.
Hooray.
Daisy,
I can talk.
Now, I'll surprise her. I'll go out and sell all my brushes, and then, being a success, I'll ask Daisy to... marry me. I waited all my life for this moment. I will now go in and ask her to be my... My dear fellow, I can't understand a word you say.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special bulletin from Duck One. We switch you now live to the control tower.
Duck One, this is the tower. Your go for final approach heading 12 degrees south-southwest. Come to 5,000 feet, over.
We don't have that many feet.
I didn't quite copy your last...
Boy, this is fun, Chip. I've never flown an airplane before.
We've routed other traffic away. You're cleared for landing immediately. Get that plane down here this minute.
Donald Duck's birthday tour is rolling on. Fans have been gathering since early morning for a glimpse of their hero. Stay tuned for the celebrated Duck's imminent arrival.
Next, Donald's lovable animated family joins the celebration.
America is skyscrapers. The Mississippi, ice cream, barbecues, and good white bread. At Gardenia, we bake that kind of bread with fine texture and good nutrition. What's in it is on it. Gardenia, Singapore's first American bakery.
Ronald McDonald meets the Fry Gang.
The telegram, Ronald. Telegram.
The Fry Gang is coming, so you better be brave.
A singing telegram.
They'll be here at noon, and it's French fries they crave.
Oh, my. The Fry Gang. They're coming.
They're here.
This calls for my famous quick draw.
Fries, guys.
French fries, fries, fries.
It's just the French Fry Guys.
I knew it all the time.
We're all joining the Fry Gang.
At McDonald's.
Take home an adorable handmade fry guy, free with purchase of every large order of French fries at all McDonald's now, only while stocks last.
Come to the zoo, everybody. There's so much to see. Visit the zoo, baby.
Or come and see me.
Come and see our colorful mandrills in their new open enclosure now.
We want water! We want water! We want water! We want water!
Every time Duck One touched down, thousands of enthusiastic fans rolled out the red carpet for their hero. Donald didn't invent the verb to party, but he sure knows how to throw one. 14 cities in 4 days, and the crowd just got bigger and bigger.
The main love interest in Donald's life is the one, the only, Daisy. They've been together for some 47 years now. Their respect for one another has ripened with age. Daisy is the only duck that can match Donald in spirit, temperament, and most importantly, keep up with that duck on the dance floor.
I got a gal named Daisy. She almost drives me crazy. Got a gal named Daisy. She almost drives me crazy. She knows how to love me. Yes, indeed. Boy, you don't know what she do to me. Tootie Fruity, oh Rudy. Tootie Fruity, oh Rudy. Tootie Fruity, oh Rudy.
What a dancer!
Huh?
Oh, goody, goody, goody! How beautiful!
Donald first met Daisy on a trip to Mexico in 1937. Although they never married, they have enjoyed their share of foul play.
Wee, 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 wee,
and the heartthrob Daisy, Donald finally met his match. It's no surprise that Donald has never married. Just getting up in the morning to that voice would drive any sane duck quackers. Although he has enjoyed an ongoing romance with Daisy, and his three nephews, Huey, Dewey, and Louie, spend a good deal of time with him, Donald is still basically a loner. To understand why, we consulted the noted psychiatrist, Professor Ludwig von Drake, who has delved into Donald's personality on more than one occasion.
Psychoanalyzing a mixed-up duck was the most confusing case in all my 40 years of practicing psychiatry. After 76 consultations, he was getting nowhere. I was getting somewhere. I was getting as confused as he was. But I knew that somewhere in Mr. Duck's subconscious lay the answer. Please, Mr. Duck, are you sure you left nothing out?
Well, there's one other thing. I do have a strong temper.
What's that? I can't understand a word you say.
I said I have a temper. Don't it? Don't you understand English?
A temper? Oh, that's good. Now we're really getting somewhere. That's beautiful. Oh, please tell me all about it.
Well, for example, yesterday when I went over to Daisy's house.
Had a slight temper, all right. No wonder his road to romance was so rocky. Oh, what a beautiful temper. At last I found the cause of all your phobias.
You have?
Control that temper and your phobias will disappear and you will have a beautiful voice.
Daisy, it's the new me.
I'm cured.
The case was closed. A triumph for modern psychiatry. Come in, please.
Dr. Von Drake, I am so delighted that I'd like to pay my bill in full.
Oh, there's no hurry, but I'll take it, I'll take it.
Oh, it'll be worth every cent, I assure you. $1,340. Oh, this is outrageous.
Please, hold yourself. Relax, take it easy.
Oh,
remember, you're cured.
You blackened it out, good girl, brother. You big crack.
Although Donald never had any children of his own, he is filled with paternal instincts. This unexpected side of his character first showed itself when he adopted his three young nephews. And from that moment on, he worked nobly, making one sacrifice after another to bring them up in the great tradition of the American family.
Donald could take it. He also knew how to dish it out. And on his nephew's birthday, he decided to show Huey, Dewey, and Louie a really good time.
Yes, here we are, Donald. And here we are. Surprise, boys. They're going to see some of my pictures.
Oh, no.
Mickey Mouse, how'd that come in here? We want to see Mickey Mouse. No, definitely not.
Oh, gee.
Oh, all right.
Unlike Mickey, Donald didn't have his own TV show, and he never let anyone forget it.
I grew up on Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck. In fact, the Mickey Mouse Club was my favorite television show. I'd come home straight from school, and I'd turn it on before I'd close the front door. I've got to admit, I was always rooting for Donald. He was bad, and I loved him for it.
Who's the leader of the club that's made for you and me?
M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E.
Come along and sing your song and join the jamboree.
M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E.
Ring me out. Forever let us hold our banner high.
Take two. Take three. Take 14. We visited the renowned artist Andy Warhol at his studio in New York, where he's working on a new painting celebrating Donald's golden anniversary.
The brilliance of Walt Disney and his team of animators was to take a creature as ordinary as a duck and make him so human. Although Walt just wanted to create a long-lasting character, he succeeded so well. Donald has become not only an institution, but a work of art.
Animation is a 20th century art form. 24 paintings are needed for every second of screen time. Sound is also critical, as Walt Disney explains.
Sound helps to give the character plausibility in two ways. First, by giving him an appropriate voice.
Oh, that's very, very true.
Second, we must have convincing sound effects. And now, Donald, would you mind helping with a demonstration?
Oh, sure. I'll be glad to. What do I do?
Take off your hat and face the audience. Now you take a real heavy object, say something weighing 3 or 4 tons. This can produce some very plausible effects, both audible and visual. First, the sound, which was made by letting a steel tank drop 10 feet onto the concrete floor of an empty swimming pool, with reverberation added. And now let's observe the pictorial result of our experiment.
That's really only half the story. Actually, it's more complicated than that. I'm here at the Disney Studios Animation Department to try and unravel the mystery of how Donald Duck comes to life. Why can't I see something happen? You know, all the ducks look exactly the same.
Oh, no, each one is different. See this one? The foot's off the ground. Now we take one picture. This next one, the foot's down. See?
Well, I get the idea, but I still, Donald hasn't moved.
Just a minute, Dumbo.
That's great.
I'll show you. Now look. First, my foot is up here. See?
Uh-huh.
Then, it's down here. Understand?
Now I get it.
And this?
Yeah.
And this?
I see.
And that? See?
Yeah, gotcha.
When I'm going faster, I'm working. Get it?
Now I get it.
Now in this picture, I'm a farmer, see? I'm doing the milking.